So here is a Wintec catamaran for Mary and Mercy. I actually just picked it up Saturday, which was no fun at all. Without the motor running, to get it on the trailer was difficult at best with the wind. So as you can see here, like, the nose is a little nicked up, and the boat has been sitting in water for a really long time because there's so much growth on the bottom of this thing that I don't even know if there's bottom paint on it or not. But the main reason it came is because it's got this big gaping hole in the side that somebody put duct tape on. Now, so far, no water is leaking out of the bottom of this thing. However, I know there's water inside of this pontoon because I saw the boat submerged. Now, can't really drain it because it's got all this foam in here. And the answer is to turn it upside down, which turning the whole catamaran upside down is difficult at best. As you can see, it came with the motor on it, which we normally don't want the motors on them when they come here, because it's such an involved process to take it off. And to turn the boat upside down, you have to take the motor off, which means that you have to take the steering units off and the shifting unit too, which means that you take off that whole tower where the steering wheel is. So like I say, it's involved. Now, here's the options. One option is to merely take this pontoon off, because it does come off. We can leave the boat the way it's sitting right now. Take that one pontoon off, clean it, and fix it. The other option is to take both pontoons off, clean them up, make sure that they don't leak. That's involved, time consuming. The other option is to not take the pontoons off, take the motor off, take the tower off, turn the whole boat upside down and work on it that way. Either way, we got some time to put into this thing. Not sure what you want to do exactly with this. The quickest thing to do to get it back to you is go under the assumption that the other pontoon is not leaking at all. Just take this pontoon off, repair it, put it back on, and keep your fingers crossed for the other one. And then normally we do bottom paint stuff, so you'll have to let us know what you want us to do. As you can see, the nose here, the core is exposed right at the lip there. Just wanted to show you how dirty this thing really is. And now the other thing, question I have for you, is that the hinges on both these seats are broken. I don't know if he wants to try and fix that. It could be an effort of futility, depending on what the lids are made out of, if they broke that easily with that little chintzy stainless steel hinge they have on there.